Dude, you gotta look on the brightest bright side there is. They won! No, I know, and I get that. It's not even that the Leafs blew a 3-0 lead to the Blue Jackets. It's that the Leafs blew a 3-0 lead to the Blue Jackets again.
Everyone forgets about the bubble, yeah.
Let's go! Ladies and gentlemen, it's a little ridiculous.
Good boy.
Play all the hits! Left Toronto Maple Leafs. Let me finish. How am I supposed to go to bed after watching that?
I'm quite hyped. With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Puppies, treat it like Iggy. He doesn't ask what the treat is made of, he asks how many treats. Was that a good one? I thought it was profound. It sounded better in my head. Leafs win! 5-4 over the Columbus Blue Jackets. And this is where you sort of got to say to yourself, how important is game 56 really? Listen, who do they got? They got the Blue Jackets tonight. They got Seattle tomorrow. They got Arizona later this week. And in an outdoor game, we will try to pretend to have a rivalry with the Buffalo Sabres. It's a rivalry that exists within the fan bases, and Jack Eichel really embraced it, and where's he? In Vegas with a team that may or may not make the playoffs, but that's a different discussion for another day. What are the overarching themes for this game? The Leafs got a 3-0 lead. That's good. 3-3, they blow the entire thing. That's bad. They end up scoring 2 more goals, including the game winner. That's good. They took a 2-goal lead into the final minute and barely held on. That's bad. So I'm gonna try something. We know the bad. All of it. What are we gonna say? The Leafs have a bottom 5 save percentage since January, whatever. Their defense is way too soft. They can't hold a lead. Okay, well, here's the great thing. We already knew that. We already knew all of that. And we're sitting here looking at the TV and looking at our phone and going, Kyle, make some changes. But in his recent comments, Kyle Dubas has all but confirmed that, yeah, the Leafs are going to make some changes on defense. And they already have with Labushkin. Now, as we get closer to the playoffs, you're going to want to see more playoff-like performances. I'm not just talking about in toughness. I'm talking about intensity, attention to detail, effort. But can we expect that in game 56? You know what's amazing? You probably don't even know that it's game 56. I could be lying right now. I'm not. It's game 56. But I could be. So game 56, 7, 8, and 9. All of those games are against teams that, no disrespect, thoroughly don't matter. Blue Jackets don't matter. The odds of them mattering in the East are very slim. The Seattle Kraken, welcome to the league, cool jerseys, don't matter. Arizona Coyotes, yes, you beat the Leafs last time, don't matter. And the Buffalo Sabres, the game should be fun. The jerseys look neat, don't matter. Win, just win. Get a garbage win, a stinky, smelly win. I don't even want to be able to tell my friends about this win. Give me sweet, calorie-rich, junky wins. Give me another 10-7, give me a 10-9. Lose 10-9, just let me see you score 9, which would be your second highest total of the season. I guess what I'm saying is my positive perspective on this game is we cannot keep acting shocked when the Leafs do the things that we know that they do. But also, we can't really get indignant with the management when they don't fix it because they said they're gonna fix it. Within the next 2 weeks, they're gonna fix it. The trade deadline is March 21st. If you woke up the morning after this game, guess what? It's less than 2 weeks away. So I am gonna focus on the positive. Let's talk about the game. So I am going to sit here and be a patient boy, a good boy. And in 2 weeks and not so many sleeps, Kyle Claus is gonna come down the chimney carrying right shooting defensemen for all the good little girls and boys. And now I wanna see that skit more than anything. Very clearly Kyle Dubas in a Santa Claus costume. Ho ho ho, who's next? And a fully grown 43-year-old man from Keswick shows up and sits down on his lap. Oh, and what would you like? You know my answer, Kyle, it's Josh Manson, yes, and it's not Kyle. Give me what I want! You asked for Josh Manson last year and I told you it was expensive. Oh yeah, like a 1st and 2/4 expensive? Aren't you a little old to be sitting on Santa's lap? Aren't you a little young to be GM of the Leafs? Okay, get him out of here! And then security hauls the 43-year-old man from Keswick off, and next in line is an adorable 8-year-old boy.
Oh, 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 and what would you like?
Josh Manson!
Sorry, I've made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
Listen, we know what their problems are. We should stop being surprised when they show up, and all we can do is hope that they fix them. To put it in academic terms, the Leafs are in that weird no man's land between the midterms and the final exam. And realistically, yes, you should be studying hard and sharpening your mind as much as possible. That's what all the best students are doing. And despite all that, can you force yourself to care? You can't. You bought a new planner, you haven't used it, you haven't even opened it. You can return it to the store if you still have the receipt. That's kind of this time of year. So let's talk about this game and the positives. The third line, the Mikheyev-Engvall-Kampf line, is on the ice, and it's gotta be a weird feeling. Kampf
knows who he is and where he is in the lineup. Mikheyev has aspirations of being higher in the lineup. Pierre Engvall knows that he's only on the third line temporarily and may not even be in the playoff lineup. But with a little help from pressure from Morgan Riley, this is a nifty goal. Riley chasing down Gavrikov, Mikheyev is right there, so he forces him into a silly goose pass. Engvall gets it, shovels it to the side to David Kampf. David Kampf puts it on, and it's blocked and pinging around. You want bread? You go to the store. You want a goal? You go to the Cobra! Ilya Mikheyev bangs in his 10th of the season, and the Leafs have the 1-0 lead. A few minutes later, animalistic shift from the top line. Michael Bunting is a bat out of hell, like an actual Tasmanian devil spinning around in the slot, breaking sticks, not his own. Truly exhausting as the Blue Jackets try to triple team him. However, reinforcements arrive, and reinforcements are Austin Matthews! Demonic shift! They can't get the thing off him! He shoots, they stop it, they throw it away, he gets it back! And I didn't even realize this, he didn't get an assist! He throws it to the point, Timothy Liljegren rips it on, Michael Bunting must have got a piece of it because he got an assist, and Mitch Marner finishes it. Once again, you want bread, you go to the store, you want a goal, you go to Mitch! A few minutes later, that line is out again, and another demonic shift. Michael Bunting, again, another really good effort. Mitch Marner repaying the favor to Austin Matthews with a blah, blah, blah. You know what? Leave it in. It's hard to do these and it's hard. Mitch Marner with a wonderful pass to Austin Matthews repaying the favor. Matthews with a wraparound and it goes in for his 40th of the season. 40th. And you're getting caught up in the milestones. Oh, his fourth 40-goal season. But even those have some sort of asterisk on it because he's played in two shortened seasons. The 40th goal for the best 60-goal scorer who's never scored 50. But he's got a lot of runway left this season. Let's not get caught up in the milestone. Can I show you the goal? There he is! There he is! How far is he from the crease? Not very far. Here, can I show you something else? Can I show you? Here's Mitch's goal. There he is. Look at Bunting. Him and Bunting are the two closest guy to Elvis Merzlikins. Can I show you something else? Here's Mikheyev's goal. Once again, two Leafs in there. Nightmare! I bring this up all the time, but here it is again. Sheldon Keefe in the Amazon documentary asked for playoff-style goals. Ooh! Yes! That's it! That's exactly what he wanted! Listen, a goal is a goal. Someone's gonna do the Michigan in the playoffs and ruin it for everybody. But typically, historically, those goals are the ones that go in the playoffs. They're the types of goals, the types of plays that the coach has asked for. And they do it. And it's weird that the team has gotten the message so clearly and thoroughly up front, allows goals the exact same way on the other end. And after the first period, the Leafs are up 3-0, and it's like a movie I've seen before.
Leafy Potter, the lead who lived, come to die.
I see your questions all the time and I'd like to answer them. My wife sleeps with a noise machine. That's how. Anyway, I promised not to focus on the bad. I did, didn't I? So I tell you what, we're not gonna talk about Corrali getting his 9th of the season or Bjorkstrand hitting 20. Sneaky good fantasy player unless your pool has plus minus. And at the very beginning of the third period, the Leafs take a penalty, and by the 2.5 minute mark in 2.5 minute mark into the third period, that 3-goal lead, it's... Where'd it... Got a hook. This is the right one, too. Oh my god! I thought the batteries were dead! That's a terrifying noise. Now here, to me, and I don't know if I'm forcing it, has been the difference when the Leafs blow a lead this year. I'm about to make blowing a lead sound heroic. They bend, but they don't break. The new look fourth line of Wayne Simmonds, Jason Spezza, and Alexander Kerfoot get out there. And Kerfoot, man, he just rips it. I want to highlight two things about this play because this fourth line has not been getting enough credit. One, it's kind of difficult to show in a screenshot, but the fourth line actually did a great job forcing a kind of ill-timed line change by the Columbus Blue Jackets, generating confusion. The puck is fed back into the offensive zone. Wayne Simmonds collects it and three Blue Jackets with him. Don't believe me? Here's the screenshot. He feeds Jason Spezza, who now has, I mean, basically the whole upper half of the Blue Jackets zone to play. A Columbus defender is on him, but then he drops it for Kerfoot and that defender has to stop dead. And while no, this is not another bang-in goal, take a look. Havoc! Chaos! In front of the net! Make their jobs difficult! They're NHL players! They're good at their jobs! Make it hard for them to be good at their jobs! That's what they do on this play and it works! And that would be the game-winning- Well, no, the Blue Jackets would get another one. Oh, man. You said you'd be positive! They get the lead. They got the lead back. And not too long after, Michael Bunting makes it 5-3. And again, what are you gonna remember about this play? The nifty little play that Bunting made with his feet behind the net? that Merzlikens didn't have his stick, as I'll show you what I remember.
Havoc! Havoc and chaos and bad times in front of the net if you are the other team. Are you a Leaf? No, you're having a bad time then.
Yes, Michael Bunting did score the goal, his 20th of the season. You always talk about the numbers, the accolades. He's the highest scoring rookie. I get it. But it's the unsung heroes of the team. The grinders, the workers in front of the net, creating space so that Bunting could work. In front of the net on this one was Austin Matthews. Dude, this guy rules. Giving the Leafs a 2-goal lead. Final few minutes of the game, Timothy Liljegren takes a real bad penalty. Oh, we're not gonna, but maybe we should, but we're not gonna. The Leafs kill it off, and then Patrick Laine scores anyway. How much time is left? 48 seconds? That's so many seconds. And as goofy as he can be, and was in this game, there was a game where he lunged at a player about 10, 15 feet out of his net and then took himself out of his net on purpose by touching that player. And that was in the first period. Positives. Peter Mrazek held the fort and won this game. And so did the Leafs. And I tell you what, when you have as many points as the Toronto Maple Leafs do, and when the Boston Bruins are as close to you in the standings as the Boston Bruins are, you do not have time to calorie count. Just eat. Manja! And tonight, they ate. Questions? So Robertson looked pretty good on that second line, eh? I liked him. I continue to like him. I held my breath a little bit when he seemed to hurt himself earlier in the game. And then he recovered and played perfectly fine. He had Willie on a 2-on-1. Willie sort of duffed it. That's okay. He was trying to repay the favor for the last game. I don't know if this makes any sense or if this is fair to Alexander Kerfoot, but Nick Robertson, in my opinion, can't be a fourth liner. Not at this stage in his career. He can't be an effective fourth liner. He's got to fly. Alexander Kerfoot, I think you can play in the top six. I also think you can play him in the bottom six. I think he can be a super effective third or fourth liner and penalty killer, PK2 guy, PP2 guy. Robertson is a goal scorer. He's got to be put in positions to score. That's what he is. That's where he's at. If this kid can really run away with it, and again, remember, I've told you, even if the Leafs don't win these next few games, I mean, this game was against Columbus. Next game is against Seattle. You can score goals there. Arizona, you can score goals there. Buffalo, you can score goals there. If he gets going, oh, it makes Kyle Dubas' job a lot easier. And Kerfoot can play on the fourth line, which makes the fourth line a lot better. The second line needs to get going, so the second line will be a lot better. And all of a sudden, the Leafs up front, already formidable, a lot better. What kind of chips is best to watch a Leafs game with? Oh, yeah, for sure. You okay, man? Can I be honest with you? No. I'm kind of okay. I'm adequately okay, but I could be more okay. But I think that's true of all of us. And if you've been listening to the podcast lately, I'm sure you've sensed it. And I'm okay with not being okay. It's what's the saying? It's okay to not be okay? I'm a storyteller. I like telling stories. And, you wouldn't believe it if I told you. But one day I will. But for now, screw it, dude. Let's watch some Leaf games. So, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really like to tell all your friends. Here's the new LFR video. We've also got a brand new Steve Dangle podcast on stpn.ca. And also, brand new episode of the Chris Johnston Show. If you haven't checked it out yet, now is the time. 2 weeks out from the trade deadline, only a few shows left, and he's got some juicy stuff. Check it out.